What's happening, TV19 sports fans? We've got a good one for you this evening. The District 622 Showdown as North St. Paul plays host to the Tartan Titans. I'm Sam Erickson, along with my partner, Alex Westad. How you doing this evening, Alex?
Doing all right. Ready for a great football rivalry here in the state of Minnesota.
Absolutely. North off to a slow start so far this season, 0-2. Tartan sitting at 1-1, and there goes your opening kickoff.
11.
Taken at the 10. Cut towards the middle of the field and got an edge. It's a great return for Tartan to start this one off. He's going to be brought down around midfield, and that was number one, Kingston Miles.
Got a couple of good blocks as he was moving up the field there. Looked like he had nowhere to go on the return as he was trapped down in his own defensive end in the corner, but he was able to find a couple of blocks and good blocking on the way up. He was able to get out across midfield, and Tartan's going to have great starting field position here as they start their first drive of the night.
Yeah, really switched it over to the other side of the field and found daylight. So good start for Tartan. He'll take over on the north 49, led by quarterback number 4, Marco Hernandez. Hernandez under center, I form behind him. He'll hand it off to Kingston Miles. Miles has some space, he'll bounce it out to the outside. Got another block, and this will be a nice game for Tartan to start this one off.
32 yards.
It looks like Miles got down to the 15.
Sam, again, same thing there on the kickoff. Just like on the kickoff, was able to break the edge, get to the outside. Once he went east to west, he was able to move up north to south. No one was anywhere close to him to get him. He broke a couple of tackles and was able to get an outstanding gain there on first down.
Yeah, nice patience on that run, too, waiting for things to kind of open up there. So they'll do it again, first and 10, this time from the 15. Hernandez under center with an I form behind him. Kingston Miles. The tailback, he'll take it and be swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage. That's number 52, Corey Gunther, on the tackle.
So contrary to the first two couple of runs there, Miles ran right up the middle, and the defensive line for North St. Paul was able to get right in that backfield. Offensive line gave no blocking there whatsoever. They were easily able to get into the backfield, stop Kingston Miles for a short little loss.
Well, it looks like a loss of 3. It'll be 2nd and 13. Hernandez under center once again is going to hand to Miles again. Miles stutter steps, finds some room to the outside, tries to go back in the middle, and he'll be dragged down.
Miles, the ball carrier on the play, brought down by number 24.
Looks like a decent gain, probably about 8 there. Bring up a 3rd and 5 from the north 11.
3rd and 5 at the 11.
Every bit of yardage that he lost there on that play, Sam, he was able to get back. Again, couple broken tackles, cut back out to the outside. Nice little run there, sets up a manageable 3rd down here for Tartan.
Yeah, definitely impressed by number 1 in white so far here this evening. Tartan wearing the white jerseys. Black bottoms, North in all black with the white helmets. 3rd down and 5, pitch out to Miles. Trying to get an edge, but he's got nothing, and North comes up big with a stop. Jeremy Weldon on the stop.
Looks like Miles is a little shaken up here, Sam. We're gonna get a timeout for an injury.
That's right. Kind of looked like his legs got caught under him on that tackle. And he is getting up under his own power. So that's a good sign for number 1. But yeah, very ginger getting up after that tackle.
Sam, I like that play where he was able to cut back to the outside. I just wish that the blocking would have been there. Maybe a couple of the guards would have pulled out a little more to give him a chance to get up a bit further, because he has great speed. He's able to cut up and get a good gain there on 3rd down. But he was able to get stopped back in the backfield, and they'll set up a long 4th down here.
There's a loss of 3 on the play.
And good anticipation by the North defense there. And sophomore Jeremy Weldon gets the tackle. We'll have 4th and 8 from the 14. Tartan's electing to go for it. No Kingston Miles, leaves with the injury from the last play. Hernandez under center. Once again, got split backs behind him. Looks to the right, fires left on a fade. Leaping forward and getting it. Touchdown, Titans.
Hernandez pass complete to number Jordan Thompson.
And that is Jordan Thompson, number six, the senior wide receiver, bringing it in. He's a big kid at 6'2", 180, and he just elevated above the defense to bring that in.
Yeah, he elevated, got a nice jump there on the defensive back. He made a good throw and a good catch there as well, as Hernandez had two touchdowns opening week against Matamidi. He can throw the ball when they need to, definitely passing down there. So a good pass, good score, great opportunity for Tartan starting off.
We'll do the extra point here. Snap is good, hold is good, kick is good. So a bit of a risk there going for it on fourth and eight. Pretty close to, you know, in a good field goal territory, but the gamble pays off for Tartan as they lead this one 7-0.
I like the play going to the corner of the end zone as well. He knew that he had a definite height advantage over the cornerback, made a couple of good reads, checked everybody down, had the most open receiver, and Tartan's able to get on the scoreboard early, which for them is a very good thing. Coming off of last season where they were 1-8, their only one win coming up against Hill Murray. So far this season, they beat Hill Murray again, but lost last week as they got blown out by Matamidi. They're off to the right start here tonight. Can they get it going as they bring their defense onto the field?
We'll see, in that whole offensive possession kind of got started with a big return for number one Kingston Miles. He left with an injury a little bit later in that drive. We'll keep you updated on his status as we hear it. Yeah, nice design on that play too, as it, you know, kind of designed it to have everybody focusing to the right. You know, we got one-on-one coverage to the left through a jump ball, and Tartan got the touchdown. Now it's North's turn to receive. Botches the return, picks the ball up, and now he's got some room to run. Almost getting to the outside, but brought down. But North will have good field position in this one. That was Ken Camoga, number two, the senior.
Ken Camoga's been on this team for a long while, Sam, and just like on the opening kickoff where Tartan was able to return the ball for a long gain, the Polars here had a bit of a good luck chance here. It looked like Camoga fumbled with the ball a little bit, but he was able to recover, get focused. His blocking gave him great opportunities upfield. Again, great starting position here for North St. Paul.
Tries the end around, handoff goes to 45. That's Luke Jeska.
Number 45, Luke Jeska, locked here on the play.
And decent gain there on first down. Looks like 4 yards, that'll bring up second and six.
It'll be second and six at the 49.
Good choice going with the run on first down. See what the defense is giving you.
Polars go no huddle. Looks like they tried the same play going the other way. This time it's Ken Camoga on the carry, but we've got a flag right around midfield. And this may be coming back.
An illegal shift on North St. Paul.
Looks like we have another injury. Camoga's down too. That can be big if both teams lost their starting running backs.
Illegal shift, Jim.
It'll be an illegal shift against the Polars.
And it looks like Camoga is still down and being attended to by the training staff.
Be a 5 yard penalty, regain second
looks
down.
Looks like he's kind of favoring his left arm. He'll walk off as well. And it's Ginger.
It'll be second and 11 at 44.
You see their head coach Eric Longton walking with Camoga. Neither of them very happy.
Looks like we'll get a second and 11 here after the penalty, an illegal shift on the offensive line for North St. Paul.
Pre-snap motion once again. This time it's going to Fazeo Adomendi, and he'll pick up a couple.
Yeah, 35.
Number 15, Devin Washenberger on the tackle.
Okay. Again, we're in third and long here for North St. Paul, their first chance. We saw a run from Tartan. I think we'll see a passing down here.
After that gain and the penalty before it, it's third and eight from the pistol. Inside handoff, but that one is squashed. And it's number 50, Devin Washenberger on the stop once again, made the stop the play before. And that'll bring up fourth down. Looks like North will have to punt it away.
No gain on the play. Fourth down.
Watch the fake.
I don't think I agree with the decision to run the ball up the middle there. I know, again, it's early in the game, but you're already down by seven. Throw the ball, see if you can try and pick up at least a first down, or at least get a little further into that territory so we can think about going for it on fourth down.
It looks like number five, quarterback slash punter, Josh Steckler gets into that one. Booming punt. That goes into the end zone. We'll have a touchback. So double duty for number five, Steckler, here tonight. Quarterback and punter. You do see that a lot at the high school level.
It'll be first and 10 Titans.
He certainly
did. 55,
52 yards. So Tartan looking to get set here on their second drive of the game, their first drive where they started on the North St. Paul 49, went five plays for 49 yards and a touchdown pass. As Marco Hernandez was able to find Jordan Thompson in the corner of the end zone.
And a lot of that play, or excuse me, a lot of that drive was number one, Kingston Miles, picking up a lot of yardage on the ground. He is not out there to start the second drive, left with an injury. Hernandez goes under center. Hand will go to number 18 off the left-hand side. He'll pick up a good chunk and be wrestled to the turf. And that is 18, Cyrus Kalkwarf on the carry, filling in for Kingston Miles.
One thing that worried about me on that play is that he looked like his hands got a little bit away from his body. He wants to be able to pull that ball into the body, make sure he doesn't fumble it here. Because again, big rivalry game here for both teams. Both teams, despite where they stand right now, they want to get out of here with a win tonight.
Second down and five from their own 25. Hernandez hands off again. And this will be close to the first down. And we do have a penalty flag on the play. It'll have a hold, so that will come back.
First down, into the 30.
Dangerous penalty there. Got to make sure to keep those hands into the body. Don't do things that'll hurt your offense here as you're pushing your team back a couple of yards.
We'll go back to the 17.
Yeah, referee's just trying to figure out where the spot of the foul was. It'll go back to the 17, and that will make it second and 15. Tartan on their own 15.
Second 13.
Excuse me, on their own 17. So interesting to see what they'll do here. Been pretty run heavy so far.
Well, the nice thing that Tartan has going for them is that their offense is extremely two-dimensional. Looks like we have movement on the line there.
Definite movement, went with the hard count. Good idea, get some yardage back as they drew the Polar defense offsides. Oh, it's a false start, excuse me. Spoke too soon, I guess I got started a little early there. And Tartan's gonna back up even more. That will make it second and 18.
Already the second down here, or the second penalty rather, for Tartan here on this drive. They're hurting themselves here, Sam, and even though they have the lead, this is not looking good for Tartan.
Hernandez under center once again. Backs in the eye. He's going to roll to the right, tries to throw one up. Javon Walker is there. He'll bring it in. Breaks a couple tackles and is finally brought down. But Tartan has the yard to gain, and that's up.
32
they're marking there. And for you TV19 sports fans, you might recognize some of these Tartan players from the basketball court. As Javon Walker, definitely a key piece for Tartan in the winter. But coming up with a huge catch there to give the Titans a first down.
Nice little read there on second and long, Sam. He did a nice job of getting out of the pocket, finding a man who was open, did a great play, was able to get an easy first down completion there.
Yeah, I gotta say, I didn't see Walker at first. Thought that was just kind of a Hail Mary, you know, just throwing something up there. It looked dangerous, but Walker got under it. We're going to throw it up again, a little bit of contact, and no call, but no completion either. That'll be second and 10.
It'll be second and 10.
Sam, looks like he has a little bit of a mismatch there. Thompson, 6'1", going on a much smaller secondary. Heard some of the coaches for North St. Paul or Tartan both screaming for a flag there. I agree with the no flag, where the ball was well over the receiver's head, completely uncatchable.
And Thompson brought in the touchdown catch a little bit earlier in the quarter, tried to find him again. We'll have second and down and 10. Handoff goes to the up back. That's 27, David Larson. He'll pick up a couple, but we'll still have a third and about seven.
Gain of three. Third and seven at the 35.
Good choice there of going with the rushing play there. Set up a nice, manageable third down.
So third down and seven. Hernandez under center, split back behind him. Back to pass, looks to the left, Thompson wide open, and he's got room to run. And it's going to be a race to the end zone, and Thompson's going to win it. Touchdown, Tartans. Jordan Thompson, his second touchdown catch of the night, and we're not even done with the first quarter.
That play all started back at about the 40-yard line when the North St. Paul defender, who I believe was number 11, Joe Rubish, fell and slipped. That created separation between Rubish and the receiver Thompson. And then all Thompson has to do is just catch the ball, run all the way down the end zone for an easy score. So far, two possessions for Tartan, two relatively easy scores here.
It looks like they're really trying to get Thompson in single coverage to see what he can do. Extra point, no good. It'll stay 13-0. As 27, Jeremy Weldon comes in and gets a hand on the extra point to knock it down. So 13-0, we got 4:52 left to go, quarter number one. North is going to get the ball for their second offensive possession.
Well, if you're a fan of the Tartan Titans, you like what you've seen from Marco Hernandez so far. So far, three completions for four attempts, 102 yards and two touchdowns already. Off to a great start already, rushing game going strong too. Kingston Miles had 35 yards before he was taken out. And so far, the fill-ins have been able to do an admirable job rushing the ball. We'll see if that continues as we move on.
Yeah, it looks like Tartan likes to be a run-heavy team, but definitely nice when you can rely on your passing attack, in those third and long situations, as we saw in the first touchdown on fourth and eight. I think that's something Eric Longton and the North Polders are going to want to key in, is that, can't let up those third down conversions, fourth down conversions, especially when it results in points on the board. Turn for North, nice tackle on the open field. 37, Alec O'Hearn.
Number 11.
Rubish, the kick returner, brought down by number 37.
Well, Rubish got the kickoff there with Camoga out of the game for now. Didn't have great blocking down the field, wasn't able to get too far. Nice job, though, of holding onto the ball, not turning it over, because a turnover here early in the game would have been very costly for the Polars.
The first down and 10 for North. They go in the pistol motion and handoff in the middle. We have a flag. And North already been called for an illegal shift. This one's going to be a false start.
False start against the Polars.
Regardless, the Polars will have to march it back 5 yards and start again.
It'll be first and 15.
First and 15 from their own 18. Number 5, Josh Deckler. Sends a man in motion. Handoff goes up the middle. And Odeyemi picking up about 4.
Brought down by 36.
And that'll make it 2nd and 11.
Nice job getting back most of the penalty yardage. Interesting decision to go here with a closed set and only one receiver out on the outside. Like to see him spread him out a little more.
And ball finds the turf. Mishandled the snap, but looks like Steckler fell on it. And North is going to keep this one. And a bit of a shaky start here for the Polars so far. They trail 13-0. And they are going to take a timeout.
Loss of three, it'll be third and 14 after the timeout.
Well, I wonder if the threat of this rivalry game here is starting to get to the Polars a little bit. A couple of missed opportunities, a slip, which allowed a touchdown before, almost a fumble turnover there. I think Tartan and, or North St. Paul needs to just take a minute. Remember, it's just a football game. Go out, run their offense. They know what they can do. As long as they execute their game plan, they can have a chance to come back and be contending here in this game tonight.
You had mentioned earlier, Alex, that Tartan was 1-8 last year, already equaled that total this year. On the other side, North St. Paul, a team that made the state tournament last year, so far winless on the season. So kind of two teams going in opposite directions. I know that team last year was pretty experienced for North, so a bit of a rebuilding here. We'll see if they can kind of get something going here. Big third down conversion at third and 14 from their own 19. 4 minutes to go, first quarter. Steckler has it, looks to his right, now looks left. He's going to scramble for it. And he almost got away, but dragged down right at about the original line of scrimmage. And there's a group of Titans on that one.
Gain of five.
That'll bring up fourth and nine. Down and nine.
24.
Well, Sam, when your receivers aren't getting open, sometimes the best they can do as a ball carrier is you just tuck it down and rush it yourself and see what you can do. Nice little gain there, but well far short of the first down marker.
Back to punt.
Steckler boots it away. A little bit short. And number one, Kingston Miles, back into the game, takes the punt, and he'll be stopped at midfield.
Returns the punt. Brought down by 27, Jeremy Walden.
Great to see Miles back in the game. Never want to see a player injured stay out for too long. So nice to see him back in the game. Of course, it does add another dimension to Tartan's offense here, as Miles has great receiving and rushing abilities. Already on the season, he's got four receptions, 117 total yards in that category as well.
So Tartan on offense, once again, good field position, just into North territory. Marco Hernandez is gonna go from under center, got Kingston Miles back behind him. Two receivers split out left and right. He'll look left, fire it short, and Tartan will pick up a couple as number 10, Tim Owen, on the reception.
3 yards.
Smart little play there. Test the secondary on a nice bubble screen. Wish you would have had a couple more blockers there to get a couple more yards. But I'm sure the Titans will take it. Got another timeout here, looks like.
And you see, once again, Tartan trying to get that single coverage and see if they can make something happen off of that.
Well, we've seen it already.
Look at how small those defensive backs are for North. It is all you got to be showing up.
So it looks like Tartan's going to take their first timeout. North has already taken one. Not sure what Tartan taking this timeout for. Maybe didn't like what they saw out there in terms of personnel.
Well, Sam, like we've seen before, Tartan has size. They have speed on this North St. Paul secondary. So it'd be interesting to see if they go back to the air there and keep trying to attack until the Polars can show this Titan offense that they have the capability to stop the pass. Because so far the Polars haven't been able to shut down a whole lot of anything.
Yeah, and I talk about how North is, you know, in a bit of a rebuilding year. One thing they really had to replace was a strong secondary, losing Bishop McDonald from last year, a guy who, I can't even remember how many interceptions he had. He just kept getting them. I did a game with them last year. He had three interceptions. Unfortunately, two of them got called back because of penalties, and the two interceptions were actually returned for touchdowns. So you talk about a playmaker, you know, that you're losing, and what that can do to your defense the next year.
Number one, Kingston Miles brought down the backfield.
And handoff goes to Kingston Miles. Unfortunately, Tartan goes the wrong way, losing a couple. That'll bring up third down and nine.
Also in on that tackle, number 21, Ryan DeMuth.
Well, just as we were talking about North St. Paul not being able to stop anything there, they broke through the offensive line, got great penetration, stopped Miles in the backfield. Again, we don't really know what the nature of Miles' injury, if it's going to hobble him here for the rest of the game, but encouraging signs for the Polders to be sure if they were able to stop a dynamic rushing threat.
We'll see what they do on 3rd and 9. It looks like North is bringing some heat. They do. Good time for a screenplay. This one goes to Javon Walker.
Go, go, go.
And
go,
he breaks
go,
a tackle, go, breaks go, a few more, go. And he's still on his feet. And eventually he'll get knocked to the turf at about the 32, but had plenty more than the first down. And Tartan will keep their drive going.
Looks
like a 17-yard gain for 84. You see, that is a big kid out there. And he can move a little bit.
He can. It was impressive to see that he broke a couple of tackles there. It looked like the Polders had him pinned up back deep in their own offense, or back deep in their own territory. It looked like it was going to be a sure loss, but then he broke a couple of tackles. Polders weren't able to get to him at all and get wrapped around him to stop it.
The handoff goes inside, and we'll have another first down for Tartan, as that's about a 15-yard pickup. And David Larson, junior fullback, picks up a nice gain there.
Need a 14 on the play. Chains move. First down, Titans.
Tartan now inside the red zone. And looking to get their third touchdown of this first quarter.
Yeah, we like what we're seeing so far. They're moving the ball with relative ease. And North St. Paul just isn't able to finish here.
Hernandez with split backs, looks to his right, rolls to his right, doesn't have anybody, he's got some trouble, and he'll be brought down for the sack. Looks like 24, Joe Schultz in on the sack.
Well, I think he just held the ball a little bit too long there, Sam.
Loss of 11, second and 21.
So clock will continue to run after the sack. Second down, 21, just over a minute left to go in this first quarter.
So it looks like we'll have second and long here, just under a minute. It'll be interesting to see if they go to the air, if they just try and run the ball, set up a little bit of closer field goal try.
They'll hand it off to Miles. He'll go left, not a whole lot of space, but does get positive yardage, albeit one.
Number 1, Kingston Miles Walker, brought down by number 44, Jake Kubatowicz, and number 54, Miguel Avina.
Well, they'll call it 2, and we'll have 3rd down and 19 from the North 26.
It'll be 3rd and 19 at the 26.
We'll see if Tartan gets the playoff, or if they're just going to let the clock run out and call it good for quarter 1. A little bit of confusion on the substitution. They'll hurry to the line. 7 seconds. Miles in the shotgun. And they'll snap it. Toss to the end zone. Kingston Miles, unable to bring it in. Just falls out of his hands as he was at about the 2-yard line. So the 3rd down conversion, no good for Tartan. That'll bring up 4th down and 19. And we're going to have to do that when we resume things in the second quarter. We will break after the first quarter. We want to thank you for watching this presentation of high school football on TV19 Sports, and we'll have quarter number 2 for you when we get back.
You've messed up your son's haircut.
Mom?
Do you A, try to fix it?
Like it never happened.
B, work with what you got? Or C, show solidarity.
Thank you, babe.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Morning, Gary. We are GetSchooled.com. You want a college education, don't you?
You know you do.
Yeah, but I don't know where to start. That's why we're here. We're free,
handsome.
Oh, I think we're breathtaking.
And here to guide you through every step of the way, starting with
attendance.
Gary, financial aid forms.
Biology homework, chief.
I got this.
Is that Bran? Colleges love extracurricular activities.
Chess really isn't my thing.
I got this. Doesn't matter. Go ahead. Picking a college, man. You and us go together like tacos and Tuesday.
And I love tacos.
Fire and ice.
Those don't really go together.
Go to getschool.com for more info.
And we're back here at quarter two, fourth down and 19. Tartan electing to go for it. Hernandez takes the snap out of the shotgun, rolls right, throws up a wounded duck.
Oh,
and North St. Paul is going to bring it in for the interception. That is Joe Donovan, number 14, senior defensive back, gets the interception. Well, we saw Tartan go for it on fourth down inside North territory earlier in the game, and it worked out for a touchdown. That time, not so lucky, as North gets a pick. But on a fourth and 19, you know, it is an interception. But the nice thing is North is a little deeper into their own territory.
I was just going to say, Sam, it seems like it was some sort of a forced punt opportunity there. But I think what the quarterback, Marco Hernandez, just has to do there, just put it down, throw it out of bounds, do something with it. Don't throw it up to even give them the chance there.
Yeah, you know, it's tough, too. I mean, on the North side, it's tough to tell a kid not to get the interception because you never know what's going to happen. But, you know, they would have probably been better off had he knocked it down. They would have had better field position. But, you know, your instincts take over, and the kid just, you know, he grabbed it and made sure his team had the ball. So quick handoff there, 3 yard gain, second down and 7. Steckler from the shotgun again. And he'll hand it off on the end around 45. Luke Jeska with it again. It kind of looks like that's what North likes to do, get a little pre-snap motion, kind of, you know, disguise who the ball might go to on the handoff.
I agree. It looks like they have the ability. On my depth chart here, I have 5 different running backs, rather, for North St. Paul, so they like to switch it up, and they like to get as many people involved in the game. We don't see senior Ken Kamoga coming back yet, though.
Well, there's 35, Fazeo Odeyemi, and he'll pick up the first down as he bowls his way forward.
Broke a couple of tackles here, did Odeyemi. Nice run there, huge drive here for North St. Paul. They have to score points here.
And Pullers go hurry up. They look to the left on a short pass. That's number 4, Good News Capedgel. And he'll pick up a few.
I think that's the first pass of the game for North St. Paul. Now they're showing that they too have a two-dimensional offense and they can run both ways with the ball.
So 4 yard pickup there on first. Bringing up the second down at 6. 10:15 left to go. Quarter number 2. Tartan leads this one 13-0. And it looks like they faked the end around there.
Odeyemi on the carry.
And Odeyemi takes it up the middle for a gain of 2.
Third,
that'll make it 3. And that'll be 3rd down and 3. So big 3rd down conversion here for the Polars. So they're finally getting some momentum on offense.
Polars so far have been 1 for 4 on third down. Third down conversions. Good opportunity to pick one up here on 3rd and short.
From the pistol again. This time a quick hitter to the right. 14 makes a move. Another broken tackle, but Tartan does a good job swarming. This will be close, but I think he got the yard to gain. That's Joe Donovan on the reception.
Donovan with a nice catch on the interception and a nice catch here gives North St. Paul a first down, a desperately needed first down as well.
You see when North St. Paul gets those first downs, they like to go quick. And they hand it off up the middle. Odeyemi gets it again. You got to imagine 35, Fazeo Odeyemi is going to get a lot of action with Ken Kamoga on the sidelines.
Well, just like with Kamoga, Odeyemi has great speed, great cutting, great vision. Like to see more carries out of him.
So Steckler ready for it again, gets the snap, hands off Odeyemi up the middle, and he'll fall forward and be looked like just a yard short, half a yard maybe, of the first down.
Another nice run by Oduyemi there. Lowered the helmet, drove into the Tartan defense. Again, another third down and manageable here for North St. Paul.
And after a couple runs up the middle, I'll be curious to see what they do here on third and short. Got some motion going. And that is number two, Ken Camoga. He is back out there. Got the first down, but we've got Laundry. And I think this might go against the North Polars. We have an illegal shift.
Illegal shift on the Polars.
And that's the second illegal shift of the half.
Replay third down.
And that could be a drive killer right there.
Well, they picked up an easily converted third down there. But now it sets up a third and long, maybe a passing down, maybe a rushing down. Now that Camoga's back in the game, North St. Paul has options.
That's interesting. I kept trying to find Camoga on the sideline, couldn't spot him. I guess I know why. He was on the field. So Steckler actually goes under center this time, rolls to the left, gets away from a Tartan defender, and he's going to have to scramble, make some moves, and he'll easily get a first down, getting across midfield into Tartan territory. It looks like they'll have it at about the 43.
Nice tackle there by Tim Owen for Tartan. Looked like Steckler was going to be tackled in the backfield for a loss, maybe even a sack, but he was able to keep the play alive with his legs. Sets up a nice first down here.
Steckler tried to hand it off, and he did get it off. Fool me. And Oduyemi actually picks up a good 6 or 7. I thought for sure Steckler still had that football and was being dragged down for the sack.
Looks like North St. Paul has found their bread and butter, Sam. Keep pounding it. Make them make a stop.
7 second 3.
This one goes Ken Camoga on the inside hand.
Camoga on the carry.
And I think he just got the first down.
Close. Did he cry around the stop?
And looks like the referee says that they did. So first down and 10. From the Tartan 33 for North. This is definitely their best offensive possession of the game by a long shot.
Well, again, they've been able to keep the ball moving on the ground, and so far it's worked for them. Looks like we have movement.
Ruben, I think this might be a false start. And indeed it is.
Be a false start against the Polars.
That is either the third or fourth penalty, pre-snap penalty for the North Polars.
It'll be first and 15.
Yeah, four penalties already. Starting to hurt them here. A couple just on this drive where they pushed them back.
And a frustrating thing about those penalties too is, I mean, that's just kind of mental mistakes. You know, it's not like, you know, an aggressive, like a face mask or something like that where, you know, it sometimes just kind of happens in the run of play. Oduyemi with plenty of room, and he almost gets the first after that penalty.
Looks
like he gets about 12.
Broke a couple of tackles there. Ankle tackles are not going to bring a runner down with Oduyemi's speed. So you have to hit him somewhere where you can get into him and drive him down to the ground. Tartan just couldn't do that there, Sam.
Yeah, he looks like a load to bring down. Got a low center of gravity, and he's got room to run. You see he likes to lead with that head. They really have found their bread and butter with Oduyemi here. He's picked up the majority of the yardage on this drive. And North St. Paul trying to go quick. And looks like they caught Tartan on a substitution. And Tartan forced to call a timeout.
That's their second timeout.
Second timeout of the game already here for Tartan, Sam. This no huddle, this quick action, while it's also frustrating up to us broadcasters here in the booth, it's frustrating for Tartan's defense too. We see substitutions coming in, coming out, rushing very quickly. It's not what Tartan wants to see, but it's great for North St. Paul.
I mean, that's a tricky thing kind of with that hurry-up offense is that, you know, on the defensive side, Tartan wants to get fresh bodies out there, but, you know, what North is doing is trying to prevent that from even happening. So looks like they just got caught in between there and were forced to call a timeout. Kind of the second time this happened, they've used a timeout that they maybe would have liked to keep in the bank for maybe a little bit later. So 6:27 left to go, second quarter. Tartan leading 13-0, but North on the drive here.
First and 10 at the 13.
We hear the student section for North getting into this game here, finally having something to cheer for. It's a great rivalry between these two schools. Not sure who took the ball there, but now you see it's Odeyemi, and he has stood up.
Number 35. Odeyemi on the carry. Stopped by number 69, Benjamin Heath.
Looked like a short little gain in that play. Good decision.
Keep going with it.
No, go on. 69, Benjamin Heaton on the stop. Senior defensive lineman.
It's Panini.
Hand off Komoga, left hand side. Tries to get an edge, does, and he'll go into the end zone for a touchdown.
Ben Komoga for a touchdown.
Again, Komoga, part of this great speed attack on the ground for North St. Paul. He had one guy who was about to tackle him right at the 10-yard line. But like we said before, ankle tackles are not going to stop runs. As a result, Komoga was able to leapfrog over it. He's gotten to the end zone. This game is getting close.
Tartan 1-for-2 on their point after touchdowns. We'll see how Yuseng Lohr does here. Going to try and make it a 6-point game. Steckler to hold. Snap good, hold good, kick is good.
Extra point is good.
We've got a 13-7 game. 5:52 left to go in the opening half here at the District 6-22 showdown.
Very impressive drive there for North St. Paul, Sam. Started at their own 5, went 16 plays for 95 yards. Also, for time possession as well, they took 6 minutes 39 seconds off the clock. Definitely a step in the right direction for this North St. Paul team that we expected to be contending for a tournament appearance again this season.
And for a team who really had done nothing on offense, how impressive is that 95-yard drive? I almost said 95-play drive. Felt like it at times, but a 95-yard drive to get into pay dirt and cut that lead pretty much in half. In fact, go a little bit past that to make it 13-7.
It's going to be important to see how Tartan responds. Do they respond with a touchdown, or will mental errors continue to haunt this Titans offense of late?
Yuseng Lohr boots it high into the night sky here in North St. Paul. Kingston Miles with it, had a good return to open this thing. And he gets out to the right-hand side, still on the sideline, and he's going to go. Yuseng Lohr there, but nothing but end zone for number one. And a big play for Tartan after the touchdown from North. And boy, I thought he surely went out of bounds there at some point, but was able to tightrope walk the sideline and make it all the way in for 6.
Very, very good return there for Tartan. Looked like you were saying, he was right on the sideline. Tough to see from our vantage point if he had stepped out of bounds at all. But great offense, great blocking up the field. No flags, way to keep it in bounds. Outstanding little run there off the kickoff.
Yeah, Kingston Miles appears to be a player that's really important to Tartan. Left the game briefly, but has had a huge impact when he came back.
Extra point is important here now. 1-for-2 already.
And kick is up, and it is good. Tristan Weaver, number 20, the senior kicker, kicking it through the uprights. And that'll make it 20-7, 5:39 left to go first half. And that's got to be a little bit devastating to North St. Paul after putting together quite a drive to get back into this one.
Well, we can feel it from here just being in the press box. It's definitely brought the air out of the stadium a little bit on the North St. Paul side. But when we look over to the Tartan side, they got guys doing push-ups now. They love it.
What's that?
That's right. I'll have to get a shot of that student section over there for Tartan. Oh, there we go. Great shot. They brought the camo gear out there. They're on the hunt is the banner you see there. Nice solidarity by the away fans. See that a lot these days where they kind of have an organized theme to their outfits when they travel.
Number 20, Tristan Weaver to kick off. Number 2, Ken Kamoga. Number 14, Joe Condon, back deep.
Well, Sam, the two schools, as we talked about before, in the same district, only 3 miles apart. Makes complete sense why both teams would travel here to North St. Paul for this excellent matchup so far tonight.
Yeah, definitely makes for a great atmosphere out there. And what you gotta love about this rivalry, a little bit more of a friendly rivalry, you know, with the two communities being so close together, two schools being so close together. So when it's all said and done, a lot of friendships, a lot of families on both sides.
I'm sure many of these players on both sides have played rec league football games with each other. That's how close these communities are.
So Tristan Weaver to send it up. And it looks like 14 Joe Donovan will take it at about the 10-yard line. Looked outside, tried to cut it back in. And he'll get slowed and stopped around the 29-yard line. Looks like 16 Andrew Johnson on the stop.
Nice return there for Donovan. Sets up a reasonable field position for North St. Paul. For Tartan, though, a couple of jersey tackles, like we've talked about, wrap him up. Make sure he can't escape the tackle that you're trying to make.
So Steckler go from the pistol, hand it off inside. Ken Camoga gets wrapped up around the head. No flag comes down. And it's like a short loss.
Number two.
And we'll have second 11. Looks like just no gain. Got back to the line of scrimmage.
Not surprising to see North St. Paul keep running the football here. It worked so well for them on that last drive with just about 5 minutes to go here in the second half, or the first half, rather. They might try and keep going with it, burn more clock.
Low snap, Steckler picks it up off the carpet, throws it deep, little underthrown, a lot of battling along the sideline. We do have a flag. And not sure what this call is going to be. Two players were battling, both kind of went out of bounds, came back in.
You can't call him kids. He's probably picking up way along.
And looks like good news, Capedula of North St. Paul is motioning for his team to move it forward. Referees are going to have a little discussion.
Looked like we had a little contact on the far side there between receiver and the cornerback. Definite grab by both players. It'll be interesting to see what they call here.
Because now it is a penalty to go out of bounds and be the first person to touch the football. But now if he's forced out of bounds and we have a interference penalty.
It's on North.
And we're going to have a hold against Tartan, which is declined.
Oh,
what? Come on. Defense declined. First
penalties on each team.
Penalties on each team. I think it was hands to the face call there.
I'm not sure on that signal, Sam. I've never seen that one before in all the years I've watched football.
Yeah, it looked like the ref wanted to make a phone call.
Looks like a 15-yard penalty here.
So big penalty. Both penalties going against Tartan there on the battle on the far side.
Looks like the
not sure how the Tartan faithful feel about that one.
Yeah.
Result of the penalty will be first and 10
ballers
at their own
44. One of them must have been a live ball, the other one a dead ball, both on target.
Not really sure about the call there, but
maybe something away from the play. Tartan showing pressure, they'll bring it. Handoff goes to the outside. Camoga doesn't have an edge. And 43, Tyler Maruska on the tackle.
I'm sure Tartan's frustrated by that call there. Nice stop there on first down. Able to keep contain, keep Camoga inside the hash marks. He was able to not get a huge pickup there on first down.
You saw there Tartan bringing some extra pressure up the middle, trying to deal with these inside handoffs. Good idea by North to go outside there. Looks like a double handoff, ball's on the ground, and North gets it back. And that's the risk you run with those types of plays. I do like, you know, throwing a little wrinkle into the offense there, but got to secure the football.
That was very, very dangerous. Not only do they almost lose a football, but they lose 6 yards on that play.
You got to wonder with them having a lot of success with simple handoffs up the middle, maybe a bit of a curious decision there. Odiemi now gets the handoff. Flag will come in. Looks like Odiemi got a little bit past the original line of scrimmage. We'll see what the call is. It's going to go against North. And I think it's going to be a hold. We'll see what Tartan elects to do here. If they decline, it'll be fourth down. And it looks like Coach Aaron Mullen is going to decline that one.
Smart call there to decline the penalty, set up fourth down.
It would have been about third down and 25 had they accepted the penalty, but I agree. I like the decision to just decline the penalty, make it fourth down, and force North to punt it away. Especially when you got number one Kingston Miles standing back there. We'll see what Steckler does. Steckler gets into it. And it's a little bit short and rolls out of bounds. So not a bad punt, actually, you know, getting away from Kingston Miles and allowing no return. Tartan will take over on their own 23rd. That's actually one of the worst field positions they've had to start a drive so far here tonight.
Well, the thing with Steckler being your punter, too, is that you never really know if he's going to punt the ball or if he can throw it. Because the way that North St. Paul sets up their punt game, they have the ability to also throw the football. So it's a very dangerous option that North St. Paul has, should they choose to use it as we continue to wind the clock down here in this game.
I think that's definitely something to pay attention to if this thing's close a little bit later on in the game. So Tartan will have it first down and 10, their own 23, 3:16 left to go in the opening half. Tartan leading 20-7. Handoff goes inside. And fumble! North St. Paul on the recovery. Number 5, Trey Martin drops the ball. And 11 on North St. Paul, Joe Rubish, there to pick it up.
The running back, Trey Martin, there made a huge error. He did not keep the ball into him. And as Joe Rubish was able to come in there, scoop up that fumble, it all started with the tackle that was trying to be made as well, because the way that he spun him around, just the spin and the torque on that spin let that ball come loose. So now North St. Paul has a chance to add some points to the scoreboard.
Hand off Odiemi again. He'll get down to about the 20. Gain of 6.
Again, we see North St. Paul continuing to push the run here. Getting the huge gains going for the Polars, already 120 yards rushing on the ground.
Second down 4 now, Steckler under center. Gonna send a man in motion, hand it off inside again. Odiemi carrying everybody with him. And he definitely have the first down after that second effort.
What strength by Odiemi and commitment by the offensive line to push back the defensive line for Tartan as they're able to get that first down. It looked like after he was met basically immediately at the line of scrimmage, he was able to get a nice push and get over for that first down.
Ken Camoga now on the inside hand going off to the left. It'll be kind of interesting to see Tartan running kind of that 4-4 defense with the four defensive linemen, four linebackers. It'll be interesting to see if these inside handoffs keep happening, but they'll kind of start moving one of those linebackers inside, or, you know, onto the line, make it more of a 5-3.
Well, Sam, like we talked about before the game started, that 4-4 protects against the run a little bit better as you're able to clog up all the holes.
Odiemi drops it on the floor, but I think he fell right onto it. So ball security becoming an issue here. Both sides. And we're down to about a minute and a half and counting here. Second quarter. North threatening, trailing 20-7.
Setting up 3rd and 6 here, manageable. I'd like to see Steckler try and throw, just like Marco Hernandez did. I'd like to see him throw a little fade to the corner of the end zone here.
So 3rd and 6. Under center, they go inside to Odiemi. And that time he's got nothing. Number 69, Benjamin Hedin, blowing that play up. So fourth down. Fourth down and about 6. Time still running here, under a minute. And Hussein Lohr is going to kick the field goal. Steckler to hold. Steckler's got the snap, puts it down. And Hussein Lohr hits it just to the left. And that is no good. Boy, I thought that went through the uprights there. Pretty borderline. But the referee signaled no good. And Tartan really dodging a bullet there.
Looked like he missed it just to the inside on the left side of the upright. Maybe closed the foot a little too much as he was approaching the ball. Missed points for North St. Paul, though. Not good, not good.
Now, what do you feel about that decision to kick the field goal there, Alex?
Well, I think when you're at home and you're down a couple of scores now, I think it makes sense to just go for it. Because you're going into the half, you get the ball as you come into the second half. Why not go for the end zone, try and get some more points on the board so that way that deficit gets cut from two possessions down to one.
Yeah, it was tough. That fourth down was just kind of in that uncomfortable territory of, you know, it was a little too long. You know, North has not been passing the ball a whole lot in this first half, so maybe that was led to a little bit of the decision making there. Tartan's going to take a knee, and we'll go into the locker room. And it looks like they might have to do it one more time.
But still, though, fourth down, you give the ball right back to Tartan. They might do this exact same thing. Take a shot, see what happens.
As I think both teams are just awaiting the clock to tick down to zero. And it eventually does. So Tartan is going to take a 20-7 advantage into the break. We want to thank you for joining us in this first half, and we will have that second half for you when we come back. This is TV19 Sports. Our first half, Tartan leads this one 20-7. North, of course, getting the football here first, and Ken Camoga has some room to run, and he'll get just past midfield. But hold on a minute, we've got some laundry back at about the 29-yard line.
Number 12, Xavier Pinnock's on the tackle.
Maybe a block in the back or something coming here.
Yeah, I'm guessing it had to be on the return.
Nice little run, though, by Ken Camoga to get things going here. This is a huge drive for North as they look to get their offense going again.
Definitely. We saw they had a 95-yard touchdown drive near the end of the first half.
It'll be holding against the Polars.
Definitely their best offensive production so far tonight. And they're going to want to build on that here to start off the second half. Saw a lot of runs in the run inside.
First to 10 for the Polars.
Gave a lot of 19. Success on that scoring drive.
Well, I think if they keep the ball on the ground and only go to the air when they have to, it's been working so far against Tartan tonight.
Yeah, and they'll start it off going inside Tartan there.
Odiemi on the carry.
Yeah, it looks like Odiemi maybe got one.
Brought down by a number of Titans.
Well, if, like we were talking about there, if Tartan wants to stop this rushing attack that North St. Paul's been able to get going, they're going to have to start cramming the box and stopping the runs up the middle, because that was what was really working for North St. Paul.
Steckler actually going to go under center here. Spent a lot of the first half in the pistol. Pre-snap motion, ball on the ground, and Steckler's there to fall on it.
You know, Steckler on the fumble recovery.
That's probably the third or fourth time we've seen North St. Paul have some issue with the snap and exchange. Thankfully, this time they fall on it.
Well, the first couple of times they were in that pistol set where a missed throw a couple of degrees left or right makes a huge difference. But that time where he was under center, he just has to make sure he has his ball. Has the ball in his hands before he pulls back and is able to make the play go.
So Steckler returns to the pistol, third down and 10, looks to his left, rolls that way, looking for an open receiver, now spins back to the right, and he might have some room to run, gonna need to pick up some blocks to get the first down, and he won't get there. as he's crunched going out of bounds by the Tartan defense.
Steckler.
Looked like number two, Blake Conroy, and number 43,
Blake Conroy and
Tyler Maruska.
Tyler Maruska on the stop.
Well, Steckler did a nice job of extending the play there. It looked like, again, Tartan had him down on the far side of the end zone, but he was able to use his legs to escape the sack. Then he was able to make a little gain out of that. We would have liked to see a little bit more. Looked like everybody was covered deep, so he made the best of the play that he could.
Steckler to punt.
So nothing doing on that opening drive for North St. Paul. Josh Steckler, quarterback, also back to punt.
For the Titans.
And he'll get it away. Kicks it away from number one, Kingston Miles. Number 10, Tim Oon, will take it. He'll break up to the right. Makes another man miss. And he'll pick up some nice yardage. Eventually being brought down inside the 45.
Owen on
punt return. Will start over, start with it, first and 10, inside North Territory.
Pouncey and
well, special teams have
Schultz
been a bit of a problem tonight.
As
we can see, this is another string where Tartan has had a great starting field position because North St. Paul hasn't been able to run on special teams.
45.
We had where Tartan started with the ball both now on the for their second time where they start the ball on the North St. Paul side of the field because they can't make the tackles, make the breaks, and are able to stop them in a decent field position.
Yeah, really the only time that Tartan started with the ball in their own territory was when Josh Steckler actually got it out of bounds on the punt, and it was around the 20-yard line. So Marco Hernandez leading the Tartan offense out on the field once again, under center, hands it off, and that's number one, Kingston Miles, who charges ahead
Kingston
for about four.
Kingston Miles on the carry, brought down by number 21, Ryan DeMuth.
We like seeing Kingston Miles getting the ball on the ground again. As you may have joined us if you're joining us late, Miles went out early in the game with some sort of a leg injury, but he's come back into the game. He's a big rushing threat for Tartan, as he already has 34 yards in this game here tonight.
So now under 10 minutes left to go, third quarter. Tartan leading 20-7. Got a touchdown on their opening drive of the game. And handoff goes to Kingston Miles. He was the reason that they got that opening touchdown. Did a lot of good work on that opening drive. Didn't get the score himself, but kind of paved the way for Tartan to get into the end zone. He'll pick up three.
Miles on the carry.
And that'll make
brought
it third
down by
and
George
short.
Schultz.
Looks like about one.
Nice rush there by Miles again on second down. He was able to break a couple of tackles. North St. Paul grabbing the jersey, not doing enough to bring their runner down. Again, another
third and
manageable here for Tartan, where tonight on third down, they are 2-for-6.
So, interesting to see what they do here. They line up in the eye. Got David Larson as the fullback. He'll get the hand, pick up the first down, and keep carrying a defender with him. Does a great job holding on to the football, as it looked like number 14, Joe Donovan,
David
tried
Larson
to strip
carry,
it out of there.
Down by Joe Donovan and Dallas Hogan.
That's the kind of run that you like seeing out of your fullback, where he got the ball, 11, lowered the helmet, move, lowered the shoulders,
Titans.
Drove into the defense, and he kept the legs churning. When North St. Paul first met him, they could have had him stop, but because he kept his legs churning, he was able to keep pushing and pushing and pushing, and not only get the first down, but set up a really good chance here again for a score.
And I was definitely keying in on Larson there. I thought for sure he would get the handoff. He does. Tartan just kind of imposing some of their will. Hernandez on the play action. Looks to his right. Throws it deep. Javon Walker's there. He'll make the catch and go out of bounds at about the 2-yard line.
Hernandez
nice pass from
number
84,
Javon
White.
Walker.
We saw Walker have a nice grab in the first half.
Out of
starts off the second half with a nice grab
23.
As well.
First and goal.
That's an easy
Titans
pass for Marco Hernandez to complete there. He had a man who had beat his cornerback. Again, we talked about all game how the size of Tartan has huge mismatches defensively for North St. Paul. He was able to get past that secondary, and all he had to do was just put it over the shoulder. Easy score. Too bad he couldn't keep it in bounds for the touchdown.
Yeah, no kidding, good size. Javon Walker goes 6'5", 240 pounds. So first down and goal. From the 2-yard line, handoff inside Kingston Miles, and he's got it for the touchdown.
Kingston Miles in for a 2-yard touchdown.
And where North can't capitalize on their opening possession, Tartan does here in the second half, and they open up their lead to 26-7.
We like seeing the rush there, right on first down. Again, you have four chances to try and put the ball in the back of the end zone. You know Miles has speed. You know he has the power to kick through that defensive line.
Nice run.
Yeah, I like the play call there, and it looks like Tartan's going to keep their offense on the field. Missed an extra point in the first half. Going to try and get it back here with the two-point conversion. So one receiver out wide left, one to the right, split back behind Marco Hernandez. He looks to the left. Now he's going to try and tuck it and run. Hit as he throws. Ball up in the air. And it'll fall to the turf.
Pass intended for
Thompson. Two-point conversion, no good.
Tartan will continue
to lead 26-7.
8:23 left in the third quarter. Tartan Titans 26, North Carolina 7.
I guess it made sense just to throw the ball into the end zone, hope for something.
Anchor Bank,
looked like the ball might have been holding up there for a receiver in the end zone or for North
St.
Paul to get the interception there. But either way, it's still a three-touchdown game. North St. Paul looks to be out of it, but their sideline doesn't seem to be that way. They're shouting, they're excited, they're energized. They're looking to get back into this game with tons of time on the clock, maybe take that lead and send their home fans here happy.
Yeah, and if that opening drive for North here in the second half wasn't big enough, this one is very big. They're going to have to do something before this one gets away. What do you think of the decision there to throw the ball on the two-point conversion?
Well, Sam, I think it was a good switch-up because they saw in the touchdown run where they handed it off to Miles.
Joe Donovan.
So I think
back
by switching it off or using a pass of some kind, might throw off the defense. Looked like, again, he had somebody open, but the pocket just collapsed around him. He wasn't able to get off a good throw, in time.
Definitely. And I think with the score where it is, that's a gamble you're probably more willing to take than if it was a one-score game. Regardless, no good. Tartan still leads 26-7, 8:20 left to go here in the third quarter. Ken Camoga got some room, gets out of a tackle, and he's got even more room. And he'll dance along that far side sideline, eventually cut it back. But we do have a flag that came in very late, and we'll see how this affects the play.
There is a penalty marker on the field.
If this goes against North, this could be really problematic, as that was a great run by Camoga. He had one to open up the half that got brought back because of the flag. And it is going to be a hole. The Polars, penalties are really starting to mount for the Polars here.
Not the first time that the Polars have had a bad penalty here in this game. Again, they would have had first and 10 from the 45-yard line of Tartan, but now this ball pushes them back. They'll set up at their own 29. Good field position, but not where you could have started.
It'll be first and 10 Polars at their own 29.
First and 10, 8:11 left to go, quarter number three. North St. Paul trailing 26-7. We want to thank you again for watching this presentation of high school football on TV19 Sports. Handoff goes to the outside, Ken Camoga, and he'll pick up about 3 yards.
Camoga on the carry, number 43. Tyler Maruska on the stop. Be a gain of two. Second
down. I can feel the rain starting to fall down a little bit here. As we look into the lights, we can see that it's starting to drive a little bit.
Well, with this incoming weather, it looks like we might have to wrap things up here. Unfortunately, might not be able to bring you the conclusion of this one, as inclement weather is going to be coming in. There's an incomplete
pass.
No call, and the North supporters are really starting to have some gripes with the officials now.
It'll be third and eight.
Well, we're going to break here. We want to thank you for joining us on TV19 Sports.